Hi guys, welcome to another video by Darklink Does Math. The content in this video is geared towards 6th grade math standards. These videos are public so that my students may access this information easily, as well as anyone else looking for math help. I hope you find this video helpful. If you do not, I hope you can find what you're looking for elsewhere. There's a lot of information out there. Be aware that I'm not perfect, so there may be the occasional mistake. I apologize in advance if this should happen. So today, we're going over histograms. This is just going to be a mini lesson. I'm not going into great detail. I'm simply going over the basics of what a histogram is and how to make one, given a template, and how to quickly interpret it. If you're looking for more detailed explanation, I have another video on histograms. All right, we have two vocabulary terms to go over. First is histogram. Histogram is a data display. That divides the range of data into equal intervals and it shows how often each interval occurs. So a data display that divides your range of data into equal intervals and it shows how often each interval occurs. So I have a template down here. We have a specific interval and they're equal. You'll notice 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we're going to show how often that occurs. Our second vocab is outlier. Outlier is an extreme or rare occurrence of a value. A quick example. Let's say I have some values such as 100, 100, 100, 90, 80, 70, and 20. We'll notice that these numbers seem to kind of flow and go with each other. This 20, however, just doesn't seem to fit with the rest. So the 20 would be our outlier. Seems a bit extreme or random and doesn't fit with everything else. Again, the idea is doesn't fit with the rest of the data. All right, so our first example is the table shows the number of goals by a basketball player in a season. So we have their number of goals. They made 0 to 1 goal one time, 2 to 3 goals three times, 4 to 5 goals five times, 6 to 7 goals seven times, and 5 times they made 8 to 9 goals. Our top row represents what we're going to place on the x-axis. And the bottom row, our frequency, which is how often something happens, is going to be represented on our x-axis. So our task is to complete the histogram to display this information. All right, so I already have a pre-made template. And you'll notice that our range of goals from 0 to 9 has already been divided up into equal intervals. And again, this is our x-axis. So I need a title. You can typically use what is written in your chart as your titles. It just needs to make or match what these numbers represent. So the number of goals, that's going to be our x-axis, and number of goals sounds very specific, so we're going to use it as our title. number of goals. So we made 0 to 1, 2 to 3 goals, 4 to 5 goals, 6 to 7 goals, or 8 to 9 goals. We're also going to split these up. All right, next. Frequency. This is how often something happens. Again, this is going to be represented on our y-axis. All right, next, we're going to make our bars. Now, with histograms, our bars will touch. They will connect and be side by side. They will not be separated by any space. So first, how many times did this player make 0 to 1 goals? One time. So we're going to go up to 1. We're going to draw our bar up to there. So notice our bar touches the axis. There's no space in between. Next, how often did he make 2 to 3 goals? 3 times. So we're going to go up to 3. Notice it touches the previous bar. It's a continuation. So 0 to 1, 2 comes right after. That's why those bars touch. Next, how often did he make 4 to 5 goals? 5 times. So we're going to go up to 5. 5 is right there. Next, how often did he make 6 to 7 goals? 7 times. And then last, how often did he make, or she, make 8 to 9 goals? 5 times. So again, you'll notice that this is not a bar graph, it's a histogram, so it shows a continuous flow of data. All our bars are touching. There are no spaces. Now, if something happens 0 times, well, then your bar will not be any higher than this line or the x-axis, so there could potentially be spaces. All right, so are we missing anything on this? We have our title, our numbers, our title, our numbers, our bars. We don't have a primary title. So what is this about? It's about the number of goals in a season for a player. So we're going to say number of goals in a season. So we have our 6 parts of our histogram. All right, we're now going to briefly describe the data. When we briefly describe the data, typically we're going to outline 3 to 4 things. In a previous video, we went over 3 specific things. We're now going to add 1, which is an outlier. So in the previous video, we discussed describing the shape, then the range, then making a conclusion, and we're going to add 1 topic now. Outlier. Are there any outliers? So if it does have an outlier, we're going to be very specific and discuss what it is. If it doesn't, we'll just say no. So first, the shape. So I'm going to show my work in red for this. All right, so for the shape, we're going to look for the mode. Mode is what happens the most. Well, most of the time, this player scored 6 to 7 goals. They did that 7 times. So this is our mode right here. We're going to count the data values on the left side. Now you'll notice I was writing these numbers every time. This is, or will make it very quick to count your data values. So 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 5 is 9 data values on the left. Next, how many data values are on the right side of the mode? 5. So I've got 9 and 5. So obviously there's more on the left. We should see or observe the outline. And I'll notice it's not perfectly symmetrical. There is more data over here on the left. So this shape is left skewed. Most of the data is on the left side. If just a little bit more would be on the right, we could say nearly symmetrical or symmetrical. All right, next, the range. The range is the max minus the minimum. So our maximum number is 9. Our minimum number is 0. Why don't I say 1? Well, we don't know if he made 0 or 1 goals when he was on the court at that particular time. We just know when he was on the court, one time he either made 0 or 1. We don't know the specifics. All right, so the maximum was 9 minus the minimum 0. 9 minus 0 is 9. 9 what? 9 goals. Got to have a label when necessary. Next, conclusion. Conclusions, we usually follow a pattern, like most, what, did, what. With this one, the wording is going to be a bit off or weird. This time, we've already identified that this is our mode. Our mode is not 7. It just happened 7 times. What happened 7 times? This player made 6 to 7 goals. So we can't really say most people because it's only one person. So we're going to say most of the time, all right, what did this person do most of the time? We're going to say most of the time, the player made, most of the time, he made 6 to 7 goals. So again, our conclusion is pretty much the most striking thing about our graph. The most striking thing is that most of the time, he did that. He made 7 goals. Sorry, 6 to 7 goals. All right, next. Are there any outliers? Outliers are extreme or rare occurrences. So we pretty much look. Is there anything that just doesn't fit? No. Our information flows from left to right. Everything's touching. So we're going to say no outliers. Nothing seems extreme or random. All right, one more example. Our next one is, the number of mythical creature sightings by cryptozoologists is below. Cryptozoologists, you know, those people who hunt unicorns and Bigfoot and Sasquatch, even though they'll never find them. Some of those things don't exist. All right, so anyways, these are the number of creature sightings by these people. So someone saw 0 mythical creatures. Someone saw 1. Someone had 3 sightings. Someone saw 4. Someone saw none again, and so forth. We're going to use this information to complete the histogram to display it. So we already have it pre-made. This is our y-axis. This is our x. So the numbers on the bottom, we already have our interval set up. 0 to 1 sighting, 2 to 3, 4 to 5, 6 to 7, 8 to 9. So this is primarily about the number of creature sightings or mythical creatures seen. So our title down here, what do these numbers represent? The number of mythical creatures scene. Your bottom title down here is going to be primarily what the whole thing is about. So the title down here on your x-axis is usually going to be similar to your main title. This is all about how many times did it happen. So this is going to be, again, frequency. How often did someone see a mythical creature? All right. Now all we have to do is count. Let's go ahead and divide this up real quick. All right, we're looking for how many times did someone see 0 to 1 mythical creatures? 1 person, 2 people, 3 people, 4 people, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 people saw 0 or 1 mythical creature. 8 people, or 8 times. So we're going to go up to 8. All right, next. How many times did someone see 2 to 3 mythical creatures? So 2 to 3 sightings. See 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 times someone saw 2 to 3 or 2 or 3. All right, let's go to 5. All right, next. 4 to 5 mythical creatures seen. How many people would that entail? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 people had 4 to 5 sightings of mythical creatures. All right, next. How many had 6 to 7 sightings? None. So we're going to leave it 0. All right, next, 8 to 9 sightings. Wow, like they saw a unicorn maybe 3 times, Bigfoot 4 times. Probably not unicorn though, because they really don't exist. Maybe Bigfoot though. I think he exists. How many times? Let's see, 1 person saw 9 mythical creatures, or 9 sightings. So 1 person all by himself over here. All right, what are we missing? We've got our bars, our numbers, our title, our numbers, our other title. We need a primary title. So what is this about? It's about mythical creature sightings. AKA fakeness. Because how can you see a unicorn if they don't exist? All right, so again, your primary title is pretty much going to be or closely match your x-axis title, essentially what it's about. But there's a little bit more specifics. This is primarily the number of sightings or the number of creatures seen. Okay, now let's interpret what this means. So we're going to briefly describe the data. So 4 things. We want the shape, we want the range, we want a conclusion, and we want to know, are there any outliers? All right, first, the shape. We're going to look for our mode. What happened the most? Well, most people saw 0 to 1 creatures. So our mode is right here. Now, how many values are on the left? Well, none. How how many values are on the right side of the mode? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's also just observe the outline. So most of the data, well, actually all of the data, is on the right side of the mode. So this graph is right skewed. Most of the data is skewed to the right. So right skewed. Next, what is the range? So our maximum number of creatures possibly seen is 9. Our minimum seen, which is more likely, is 0. So we're going to do 9 minus 0. And that equals 9. It's just a coincidence that 0 was our smallest number. Always be aware of what that is. And actually, it's a coincidence that 9 was the largest on both. Okay. 9 what? 9 mythical creatures seen. So, let's just summarize that with one word. 9 sightings. Again, our range is from 0 to 9 sightings. So our range is 9 sightings. All right, next, conclusion. Most what did what? Well, these are several people and how many sightings they think they saw or had of mythical creatures. So we're going to say most people did what? Well, they're seeing things, apparently. So most people saw. What did most people see? Well, here's most of our people right here. Most people saw 0 to 1 mythical creatures. So again, most people saw 0 to 1 mythical creatures. Again, it's usually going to follow a pattern of most what did what. So most people saw 0 to 1 creatures. Our previous example was most of the time the player made 6 to 7 goals. That one was a bit harder to write. All right, last one, outliers. So anything extreme. If we look at our graph, we'll notice that most of the data is right there. And it's separated. We've got this random person over here. So we've got an outlier, this person right here. It seems pretty extreme that everyone else is grouped over here with 0 to 5 sightings, and this one person saw 8 to 9. So we're going to write yes, and now we're going to explain. And it's going to follow the same pattern as our conclusion. But instead of most what did what, it's going to be who did what. One person. What did one person do? They saw, what did they see? 8 to 9 mythical creatures. I mean, that is an outlier. That's random and extreme. How could you see 8 to 9 mythical creatures if they don't exist? So again, it's going to follow the same pattern as our conclusion. We're just going to be very specific. So we say, how many of who did what? So in this case, one person saw 8 to 9 mythical creatures. All right, that is our mini lesson over histograms. If you're looking for more detail on how to make it and specific steps and everything else, you can find a much longer video on my YouTube channel. Y'all have a great day.